Hey, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell with MrCampbell.rocks.com. Google always is changing the names of things, and they just changed everything again this past week from Google Hangouts Chat, Google Hangouts, Google Meet. Now it looks like everything is just going to be either Google Chat or Google Meet. Anyways, you can see here, Google Chat, right, is a message platform built for teams. So the way that we're going to look at this today is the tutorial is for educators. If you're in the business world, we copy a lot of the things that you do in education because some of the things work really, really well, and other things we do a little bit differently because they don't work so well. But this tutorial is for Google Chat for education. So what does it look like? In your mind, you can think Slack, you can think Microsoft Teams, you can think Glip. It's kind of Google's own version of an internal messaging system to work with teams. Now, how does this look in your school? What does this look like in your school? That's yet to be determined. There is accessibility on all electronic devices. So iPads, phones, iOS and Android, desktops, PCs, everything. So all those messages will come in clear and those messages stay even if you're out of the chat for a little while or jump back in. So let's jump in and let's look at it. Let's see what it looks like. So what you'll see here is I have my school team set up here. And the principal and I were messing around with it the other day when they made the changes and kind of pushed these out. And so I've created a channel or a room, right? Not to be confused with a Google Meet room, but a Google Chat room. They also integrate very nicely. And we'll talk about that in a few minutes. I'm pretty excited about this. Because what this allows a school to do is to create those virtual teams with the teams that they already have internally in their school. And all of those are saved in Google Chat. It's a little bit different than a text message group, right? I can add and I can upload different files, images, pictures. I can go straight to my Google Drive, and I can, if I want to, request everybody to jump on. Let's meet in person and we can do a Google Meet right there. And so let's look at what we have here. So we have four people that I have conversations with, obviously, because we just got started with this. So we've added four people, but I created a test room just to see what everything looks like. So this is a Google Chat message. This is an image upload. This is something from Drive. This is a meeting invite. This is an emoji, right? Those tools. What does this look like though? What does this look like in your school? Well, if you're a teacher, think about the team that you're on, whether it's a grade level team, a department level team, an IEP team, a mediation team or a remediation team, a counseling team, a leadership team. All of those things can be built in to a chat room, and all of those can be ongoing at the same time. All right, so what does this look like? Well, we already have Google Drive, so we have notes. But there's times when we don't want to pull out that big, long file, and we want to talk about something in between the Fridays that we're meeting as a small team. We can send those now into Google Chat. We can add pictures. We can add images. Pictures and images are the same thing, excuse me. We can add notes. We can send those ideas back. So some of the work that happens as we're going throughout the day, right, in a school isn't necessarily set by a meeting time, but then when we get to that Friday meeting or that Tuesday meeting or that Wednesday meeting or whatever, we're meeting as a small team, we can pull up all of that information and help guide us through the process of whatever we're doing. Now, let's look at what this is. You can have as many rooms as you want. So if I click on these rooms, they're gonna be different rooms and different conversations that we're having with some of our members of our school. You can also set up bots to automate things. So if things get pushed in, and I'll have a whole nother tutorial about the chat bots. Ultimately though, this is a beginning tutorial. So what we wanna do, we can set our timer to mute notifications for a certain amount of time. We can change those notification settings here. And I'm not gonna go through and read all of them. You can look and see there. We can change them for mobile. We can change them for email. We can do smart reply. We can do blocked, different things like that. So we're gonna close out of settings. Now let's find a room or a bot. If I wanna send a group message, who do I wanna send a group message to? Well, let's say leadership team. Obviously I would have to have that leadership team set up for it to message all those people at the same time, which I don't right now. But if I just wanted to message one person, Curtis, my principal, it'll pull up people in my organization that I could then message. That's a direct message. Now, if I want to create a room, which I've already created, right? We can just do test room for YouTube. And we would invite people to this room. And we're going to call this number two because I already have one. So I'm going to create the room. And you'll notice what will happen is it'll come over here. Now I want to add people to that room. And I would actually go and search my organization or search my school and add that those invitees to that room. And we can have those conversations in that room. If I want to browse rooms, I could browse rooms that are part of my school or my organization leadership. Have I been invited to anyone? ERMS leadership team, I have. If I want a new thread in leadership, no, I don't want to create a new thread. Message requests. I have no message requests at this time. That's if somebody has sent me a message and they want to request a message back, which we're not going to do that time. Now, if I jump down here to the people, I won't spend a lot of time on people, but if I want to remove that person, star that person, turn notifications on or off, I can do that, right? So obviously with my principal, every time he sends me a message, I want to have a notification on my phone because he's probably got some idea or he's asking me to do something or he wants to meet or we want to talk about something that we want to do for next year, different things like that, okay? I can block, I can hide conversation, I can delete the conversation. Now, leadership, you can do the same things. So you can star that, you can turn off notifications, and you can leave. So I'm going to leave that one. Yep, I'm going to leave that room. And I'm going to leave the test room for YouTube too. We're going to leave that room. We'll go there. Obviously, these other ones I want to stay because those are real rooms that I want to be a member of. Again, I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you're an educator and you've used Teams, I know it just changed. It was Google Hangouts chat and it was connected with Gmail and there was a sidebar over there and you had to turn the chats on and off and different things like that. I'm just curious how you and your team would use this. But if you're here, that's because you're an educator and you want to do what's best for kids when they are either in the building, outside of the building, meeting with your own grade level department team. And that shows a lot about who you are, is that you're going online and trying to figure out new things and how to better serve your students. And so for that, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.